Allowing social login through OAuth providers like Google, Microsoft, GitHub, and Apple makes it easy for users to sign up and sign in to your apps. But it comes at a cost. Consider this. A user forgets which authentication method they used, try a different one than they used previously, create a new account, only to find that everything that they thought was online is now missing. That's not a great day for you or your support team. Fortunately, when you use AuthKit, we connect all of these strategies together to create one user. We do this through identity linking. Let's see how it works. On screen is my Work OS dashboard. Visiting the authentication page, I can find my hosted AuthKit site. This is the page that I direct users to sign up and sign into my application. Let's sign up for a new account. First name, last name, and email address. We then create a password and continue. We're then instructed to verify our email, which is a very important step in this identity linking process. So let's open our email and get that code. Perfect, we've successfully signed into this application. Let's see what this looks like in Work OS. Go to the users page and see our new user. The authentication method is email and password, and the email address has been verified. This is great. I'm authenticated with email and password using my Gmail address. But what happens if I attempt to log in using Google Auth? Let's jump back to the root of this login page, and this time select continue with Google. This time I get automatically signed in without having to verify my email because I'm already logged in with Gmail and that Gmail email address is verified. Now back in users, we notice a couple things. We now have an avatar. This came from my Google account. And this single user record has two authentication options, Google OAuth and email password. Okay, this is great. We have a single user record with two authentication methods. Of course, this makes sense that we could validate a Gmail account because we already have a verified email from them. But what happens when you have a GitHub, Microsoft, or Apple ID account that simply uses an email address? Let's check that flow out next. Let's head back to the root of our hosted AuthKit login page and log in with GitHub. We'll go through a typical GitHub OAuth login flow, authorizing the application, and on success, have an opportunity to verify the email used by that account. Let's grab that new code and log in. Now, because we successfully answered the challenge, our user record is updated once again with GitHub OAuth. And that's not all. We can actually look at the sessions. We can see which session was opened with which provider. So that's a quick tour of identity linking in AuthKit via WorkOS user management. If you'd like to learn more about the security and safety of this feature, we have an incredible blog post written by our team on safe identity linking. You'll learn a lot about the challenges of doing identity linking safely in a way that protects users while providing them the best user experience. That's it for today. I'm Chantastic. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.